My goodness, I feel so much at home simply because I do the same thing. I touch it and it just goes crazy. I'm sorry up there. Where was I? I feel at home simply because I turned to Father Jack and said, just let me know what I'm up. What do we do next in the worship service? You know, I used to pride myself on remembering those things, and now I just don't even try anymore. How about you? You have that problem as well? I told someone earlier that I don't have a good memory anymore, but I've got a great forgettery. The passage of scripture that was read this morning is a wonderful passage out of Luke's gospel. It's one that I had picked out, but one in which the Lord had changed this morning. And so if you don't mind, I'm going to hold that sermon in my computer for 2 years, and I'll come back and preach it. Hopefully they'll have me around, and I'll be more than happy to come back and share that with you. I have something that I wanted to share that was on my heart, something I shared this morning, and as I canvassed some of my folks that came, this morning we had a little Thanksgiving service at our church, had a little brunch, and I shared a devotion. And I was so moved by it that I wanted to share that with you, because there's some things that I believe that can be helpful for us. So they're going to hear a little bit of what they heard this morning. And one of my churchmen said, are you still going to tell the Methodist and Catholic joke? Yes, I am. Well, I wanted to say that after 36 years of being married to the same woman, I've learned some important lessons in life that husbands should learn at an early age, but we're bullheaded and don't always do. Now, I know some of you ladies right now whose husbands are sitting beside you are saying under your breath, listen to what he says next. I remember when my wife and I were first married, I thought that being a good husband was, you know, of telling her how she could better improve herself in some areas of marriage. I was very dumb. And some of you shaking your head, yes I was. I didn't realize that the moment that I said that I do, I became my wife's home improvement project for many years. I've made the mistake on several different occasions of telling my wife how she ought to feel. You honey, you shouldn't feel that way. And I realized my mistake later in life. But there's one time she came in all concerned and worried about her job. She had just started at a new elementary school. She hadn't become tenure yet, and she wanted to make a good impression on her principal, who was a real stickler for rules. And that particular day, the principal came into her classroom, my wife's classroom, and observed the teaching. Any teachers here, you know what I'm talking about. It's a very nervous, nerve-wracking experience. And so my wife came home all worried that she wasn't going to get a good score, and that would affect her grading and a number of things. And so I listened for about 2 hours of her concerns that she just blew it all. And I said, well, honey, you really don't need to worry about those things. You know, the Bible says. That was the second mistake I said. The truth is, don't we worry about big things and little things? Don't we worry about the future? We worry about the past. I think many of us worry about finances. We worry for those who are dealing with aging parents or just aging yourselves, don't we all worry about good health? It is for people like you and me that Jesus once spoke these words that come from Matthew's Gospel, the 6th chapter, beginning with verse 25, when Jesus said, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life."